Hello everyone, good evening. I hope all of you are good and I'm also fine. And welcome to my channel, Dattas Institute. So today I will take one class from physics, okay? And from class 11, from the chapter unit and measurement, and from the topics errors. And this lecture will help you for the preparation of the following entrance exam, okay? And boards. So what is error here? What is error, sir? Error is true below, minus measured value, okay. True value minus measured value is known as error, okay. So there are so many types of error are there. Suppose random error, and combination of errors, okay. Random error, combination error, and so many types: systematic error, personal error, instrumental error. So many errors are there, types of error. But today we will discuss about the combination of error. And there is combination of error. There is a formula. And first, I try to write down all the formulas of combination error. Okay. Suppose Z is equal to A plus B, then del Z is equal to del A plus del B. Here del A means error in A, and del B means errors in B, del C means errors in C, and del Z means error in Z. If a physical term is in the form of Z is equal to A plus IB, then the errors will be del Z equal to del A plus del B. Okay. Number two formula is Z is equal to A minus B. So del Z equal to del A plus del B. Again, Z is equal to, suppose A into B. So del Z by Z is equal to what, sir? Del A by A plus del B by B. And fourth, if Z is equal to A by B form, then the del Z by Z is equal to del A by A plus del B by B. Okay, so number fifth is, if Z is equal to A to the power N, so del Z by Z is equal to N into del A by A. And number six, if Z is equal to A to the power N, B to the power Q, C to the power R, and D to the power X. Okay, so del Z by Z will be what? Del Z by Z equal to N into del A by A plus Q into del B by B plus R into del C by C plus X into del D by D, okay, plus X into del D by D. So these are the six formulas from combination of errors. By using these formulas, we will do some PBSA questions, okay, from the topic. So let's start. So students, our first question. There is first question is what? If the errors in the measurement of radius of a sphere is 2%, then find the errors in the determination of volume of the sphere. So given here, the percentage error in radius of a sphere is 2%. Okay. If this one is one sphere and this is the radius, if radius has error, then automatically its volume has also be error, because volume of sphere V equal to 4/3 pi r cube. V equal to 4/3 pi r cube. Now look at here, this part is constant, okay. This part is constant and it is eliminated. This one is constant term, then every constant term will be eliminated, okay. Now use the formula of rules 5. Del V by B, 3 will be came out in front, so del R by R, okay. If you multiply by this with 100, it will came in percentage, so del R by R into 100, okay. So given del R by R into 100 is what, sir? 2%, okay. So answer will be 6%. So which option is correct here, sir? Option C is the correct answer. Option C is the correct answer. Okay, let me explain again in shortly. In the question given, this question is came in NEET 2008, that is PMD 2008. If the errors in the measurement of a radius of a sphere is 2%, then find the errors in the determination of the volume of the sphere. Four options is given, which option is correct, we have to find out. So what is given here? Del r by r into 100 is 2%. So volume of the sphere is what? 4 by 3 pi r cube. So this one is constant term, 4 by 3 pi is constant term, it will be eliminated. Now the formula will be del v by b equal to power will be came out in front. So del r by r, if you multiply it by it 100, so it will 100, it will convert into percentage error. Okay, so del r by r into 100 is given 2%, so I write here 3 into 2, that is 6%. So which option is correct, sir? Option C is correct. Okay, option C is the correct option. So so move on the next question. So students, our next question, that is question number 2, and this question is came in NEET AIIMS 2018. This question is came in AIIMS 2018. Okay, so the question is like that: the percentage error in measuring MLT are 1%, 1.5% and 3% respectively. Stop. Then the percentage error in the measuring of the physical quantity with dimension ML minus 1 T minus 1 is what? We have to find out. Okay, so what is given here? That is del M by M into 100 is 1%. Del L by L into 100 is equal to what? 1.5%. And del T by T into 100 is equal to 3%. Okay, so let the physical quantity P is ML minus 1 T minus 1. So we can convert it like that, M by L into T. Okay, so now use this formula, del P by P into 100. If I multiply again 100, it will be like that, del M by M into 100 plus del L by L into 100 plus del T by T into 100. Okay, now this part is what, sir? 1%, this one is 1.5% and this one is 3%. So answer will be 5.5%. So which option is correct here, sir? Option D is the correct answer. Option D is the correct answer. Got my point? Let me explain again. In the question given, the percentage error in M, L and T are given. There is del M by M into 100 is 1% given, del L by L is given 1.5% and del T by T into 100 is given 3%. And I take the physical quantity of dimension is P. I take P equal to ML minus 1 T minus 1. We can write M by LT. After that, I use the formula. Okay, whatever I will retain in the starting the class. After that, I put the values, all the this one is given 1, this one is 1.5 and this one is 3. So after simulation, what comes? It will become 5.5%. Okay, so move on the next question. So students, our next question, that is question number 3, is like that, and this question is came in NEET and JEE in both exam, that is engineering material, both exam this question is came. So in an experiment, the percentage error in the time period and length of pendulum are given, that is del T by T into 100 is given, sir, 2%, and del L by L into 100 is given 1%. Now we have to find out the percentage error in G is what. Okay, so the formula is like that, time period formula, root 2 by T equal to root 2 by root 2 by L by G. Now we have to square both side because we have to find out this G. So G take here, so 4 pi square L by T square. Now this term is constant term and it will be eliminated. This one is constant term, be eliminated. Okay, so the formula will be like this, del J by G into 100 is equal to, sir, this will be cancel out, and del L by L into 100 plus 2 into del T by T into 100. Okay, now come here. So del L by L, sir, go del G by G into 100 equal to 1% plus 2 into 2%, that is 5%. So which option is correct? Option C is the correct answer. So option C is the correct answer. Okay, got my point? So let me explain shortly. In an experiment, the percentage error in time period and length are given, that is 2% and 1%. So time period of a pendulum is T equal to 2 pi root over L by G. So from that we have to find out the percentage error in G is what. So for that I is squaring both side. After that I try to find out g is what, and this part is constant, it will be eliminated, and after that I use the formula and this one is came. If you just put the values of del L by L is what and del T by T is gone, and option C, that is 5% is came out. Okay, so move on the next question, sir. So move on the next question. So students, our fourth number question, and this question is also came in NEET and JEE. This question is came also NEET in, that is medical and engineering entrance. Okay, so the question is like that: the percentage error in mass and speed are, that is mass, that is del m by m into 100 is what, 3%, and del b by b into 100 is what, sir, 2%. Okay, respectively. To find the percentage error in the kinetic energy of the body, we have to find out percentage error in the kinetic energy of the body. So kinetic energy of the body is what? Kinetic energy, the formula of kinetic energy is K equal to half m b square, is not it? So this part is constant, half is constant here, so it will be eliminated. This one is constant term, so it will be eliminated. So del K by K into 100, here del m by m into 100 plus 2 del V by V into 100. So this one is 3% and this one is 2 into 2%. Okay, so there is 3% plus 4%, that is 7%. So which option is correct? None of this will be correct here, because there is 7% and here is 13%, 8%, 6%. So which option is correct here? None of this, that is option D is the correct answer. So got my point? So let me explain again in shortly. The percentage error in mass and speed are 3% and 2% respectively. Find the percentage error in kinetic energy of the body. So percentage error given, mass is 3% and speed is 2%. So kinetic energy of the body is equal to half m b square, that is del K by K. This part is constant, so it will be eliminated. So del K by K into 100 equal to del m by m into 100 plus 2 into del by b into 100. So I just put the below, just put the, all the values here, so it will be 7%. Okay, so move on the next question. So our next question, that is question number 5, is like that: if voltage across a bulb rated 220 volt and 100 watt drops by 2%, that is the voltage drop of a bulb is what, sir? 2.5%. okay, so if the percentage of the rated value by which the power would be decreased, so power drop is what we have to find out. What is the percentage of power drop? If voltage is 2.5%, we have to find out. Okay, now there is so many formulas there: power P equal to W by T, then power P equal to I square I, then power third is P equal to BI, and fourth is power P equal to B square by R. Okay, now which option is correct? We have to move. Sorry, which formula is have to we have to use? We have to find out. Now here, this one will be not, does not use, because power and time is not given. Here I and R is not given. Here B is given, but I is not given in terms of percentage error. Okay, look at here. Here B is given, but R. So if any electrical appliances, if voltage is dropped, it is fluctuated, that is sometimes it may be increase or maybe decrease. So due to increase or decrease of voltage drop in any bulb, the resistance does not change. Okay, you have to remember this, the resistance will be always equal. So here indirectly they given, indirectly what is given, del R by R into 100 is equal to del R by R equal into 100 is equal to what, 0%. Okay, so they indirectly given del R by R is equal to 0%. So now therefore power P equal to B square by R. Okay, so power P equal to B square by R. So del P by P into 100 2 into del V by V into 100 del R by R into 100. Now this term is 0, so 2 into 2.5%, is not it, plus 0 equal to 2.5, that is equal to 5%, and it is equal to 5%. So which option is correct, sir? Option C is the correct answer. Option C is the correct answer. So let me explain again in shortly. They given in the question, what is given? They given the voltage, a bulb voltage rated, a bulb rated, there is 220 volt and 100 watt. The voltage drop is 2.5%. If the voltage drop in a bulb is 2.5%, then what will be the percentage power drop? There is power decrease in that bulb, it will be what we have to find out. So they given this one is 2.5%, this one we have to find out. Now look at here, power is power, we can find in different ways power. There are four ways there from which we can find out the power. So P equal to W by T, P equal to I square by R, P equal to B I, and P square B square by R. Here look at here, in the above three there is any data is not given, but in case of four there is P square, P equal to B square by R, the voltage drop is given and resistance is constant everywhere, is not it? Resistance does not affect if the voltage is increase or decrease. Okay, power may, it may increase or decrease. So resistance is constant for everywhere. Resistance will change, and resistance does not change until the wire or filament will be changed. Okay, so this much for today. Have a nice day. Take care.